Hey guys, I'm Aerithia. Welcome back to Planet Coaster Forgotten Realms. Today we're gonna work on this monorail station and we're gonna do something with detached roofs. Last episode I made this small tower on the lower side of the town. I really like that style, so I was kind of like, I want something that will just add to the town a little bit. So let's make some sort of little village here over the water with this main building as a station. And I really like how this looks. This is probably my favorite station I've done. And I don't know why, but this is kind of the first thing that I've really done with detached roofs. That's just something that never came up before, and now I really got the chance to make some good use of that. So yeah, I really enjoyed making this building. It's very early in the morning, guys, so I'm sorry if I sound a little bit tired. I basically just woke up and yeah, I kind of just couldn't wait to get started, so here we are. My voice will probably wake up halfway the video or something. So bear with me a little bit. Okay, this week was kind of crazy. I've never built this much before in 1 week. I had no time for anything else. I've been just building, building, building. I've been trying to divide it over a few days since I've been basically just building houses. A lot of townhouses. And after a while you can kind of get burned out on it and just lack ideas, so I don't think at this point that you will see that in the background just yet. No. I kind of lost the timeline of what I did when. But yeah, there is a lot of new townhouses and I kind of finished the upper level of the town. So that's something I want to show you in real time. I felt like it's gonna be a lot of repetitiveness if I'm just gonna put that in the episode. So I just focused on this monorail station and this little village behind it. I think next episode we're probably gonna do something with a ride. I don't know what ride just yet. I'm still thinking about something with dragons, of course, because we have this whole concept in this fantasy area that you have all these different areas where different species live. So we have the fairy forest, we have the witch's cave and a part of the forest. I still want something with dragons, and now we have this small little village where maybe some other fantasy creatures live. I have no clue what that could be. We don't have that many animatronics, so that's a little bit too bad. That's always what I'm talking about when I say I want more animatronics. So that you can kind of create a story in your park, you know, with all these creatures that live there. That's something I would like to do. I know a lot of other people just do that without needing more, but yeah, I'm creative, but I guess I need a little bit of a basic thing to go off to create something like that. I would love to have some more creatures and different species so that you can actually do something with that. And if we get to that point where we get some more animatronics and some more species and something that adds to this world, I could probably create a whole bunch of new things just based off of that. The thing is, I just read on Twitter that Planet Coaster will be getting 3 DLCs. Now, this is very early on and this is on Planet Coaster Club. It's the Dutch community for Planet Coaster. And they say that the DLC tab from Planet Coaster on steamdb.info kind of spoils that we will be getting 3 DLCs. And when you look at the page, you indeed see something that looks like a space that's reserved for DLC. So yeah, I don't know what is up with that exactly just yet. This is everything we know for now, but that's really, really exciting, guys. Man, if there will be 3 DLCs, I will be very happy with that, and we can be pretty sure of that we will get lots of more stuff, and I think this game deserves it like no other. The other thing that's added to that post, the thing that kind of makes it real, is that Andrew Chappell, lead software engineer at Frontier, appears to kind of confirm this. He wrote, "Yeah, I thought someone might notice." So I think that's a pretty sure thing, and they are working really hard to get us to make this game the absolute best it can be. So that makes me so excited, and I can't wait to see what's in store for this game in the coming years, probably. But yeah, back to this building. So we will have these little houses over the water that match this larger one, and there will be tiny bridges just going straight over the water so you can reach all those different pieces of land where these houses will be. This is basically just background scenery for the monorail track. When you go over it, you go through this village before you head back to the main street. You won't be able to go there actually, like with paths. I didn't lay out any paths or anything like that because that's just kind of unnecessary. I was just basically creating some background scenery. It would be fun though if you could actually go there, but yeah, I don't think we really need that space right now. But we do have this space behind here that's reserved for a coaster. I definitely want to do a coaster, and depending on how large of a scale that coaster is going to be and what kind of concept I can come up with, maybe we'll have to cut into the pirate area quite a bit, or maybe I will have to scrap the pirate area completely. I don't know exactly what is next just yet, but that is definitely a possibility, and just throwing it out there right now because it is a pretty small space, and this is the fantasy area, so I'm gonna focus on that mostly, and when we have space left for pirates we will do something with that. But yeah, there is a chance that I just will keep it all in the fantasy theme and just wrap it up like that. We could also maybe have the coaster go over this area a little bit so that it's going through this little village as well. That would be also an option maybe. Yeah, we'll just have to see, because planning ahead is something I love to do because it gives me some sort of clarity and just room to breathe to know what I'm working towards. But at the end of it, when you're just gonna struggle with the space you have left and you have a lot of ideas of what you could do with that, yeah, things will change at the end of it. So at this point, I'm not gonna make any promises anymore or just guarantees that things will look or go a certain way. We'll just have to see where it all ends up. That's just yet another thing that I've learned from making videos. These things you kind of just have to discover by doing it a lot, and that's what I've been doing. So I'm still learning new things, like I said last episode, and I kind of have to prioritize what I feel like this park really needs still and what could be just another fun thing to add. And something that I really don't like to do is just say, okay, we need to have a pirate area, so I'm gonna make a very small and compact coaster when I'm not really feeling that right now. I kind of want a larger coaster over this area because it's such a crazy cool area, and I kind of want you to be able to see all these different areas from the coaster. I don't know if that's something that's gonna work just yet, but maybe when you're very high up you can see part of the fairy forest and you can see part of this village and the town. So that's kind of the thing that I really want most of all, so that's definitely something I'm gonna focus on more than just forcing myself to having a pirate area. At this point, I think we're basically as good as done with the houses and the building. Right now, we're just gonna dress it up a little bit with some rocks. We're gonna add these little waterfalls that I've been talking about for a while. So that's something I really wanted to get done, and it makes the park look so cool. I really love these water features everywhere. I even adjusted it a little bit to where the water rapids is. You will see that when I will go to real time, because it's kind of hard to explain at this point. But we have a larger one on this side as well, which is looking just really cool. We still need to do the queue line for this as well. And yeah, we're gonna skip through this a little bit because it's just a lot of the same, just adding plants and rocks and plants and rocks and yeah, a lot of that. So and we already skipped, so at this point we're just finishing up here, painting this area a little bit differently. So we just have a little bit of a change over here, some more rocky feel like area instead of just forest. When you make a really realistic theme park, everything is way more packed, of course. Everything is really close together, all the rides and everything. But since I'm making a fantasy area, and I mean that literally, it's fantasy, it's not realism, I just want this area to be like I've done before, just a area that exists where a theme park was built on, not so much a flatland where a theme park was built on. So this is, yeah, a little bit different from what I mostly see people do. This is just really my style. I love to get creative and have the room to do whatever I feel like I want to do, instead of holding myself to all these rules of what a theme park should be like. And I think we have enough real theme parks and enough crazy good creators that make realistic theme parks that I can just be myself and do whatever I feel like is just for me. Over here we're starting with the queue line, and I realized that I made it way too small for a path to fit on, so I just needed to move that up a little bit and make it a little bit bigger. And then we're gonna work on the queue line a little bit, and I was struggling quite a bit with this. Like I said, first it just didn't fit on this, so I had to change it a little bit. And now I kind of discovered that we have not a lot of space over here to connect it, so I skipped to where I tried a bunch of things out. The thing always bothers me a little bit is I feel like it's weird to have a full long queue line for a train station, you know? It's sort of a train station, so I feel like you should just be able to walk there and wait for the train to arrive and then just hop on whenever it's there. So instead of waiting in a queue line, I decided to make it very small and just attach it to the path that's going up to the exit right here, and just attach the entrance to that. A thing that really bothers me about these tracked rides, and not all of them, it's basically the ones that function as a train, that you need to make it fully back to the first station. That's just silly to me, because you can have an end station and you can have the train turn around over there and head back to the first station. So that's something that just really bothers me a lot. I feel like it's unnecessary to have this track go all the way through the whole park and has to make it back to the first station. Yeah, I don't know why they did it like that. Maybe it's a way with programming that I just don't understand. That's totally possible, of course. I'm not a programmer. But it just bothers me a little bit, because it just takes up a lot of space, and this one looks very sci-fi like. What I would have liked to have done is, for this park, that's something that didn't work. That's probably why it bothers me. But what I would have liked to have done is just have the older looking train. I don't know what it's called, the Iron Horse, is that it? I don't know. Have that one over here in the fantasy area, and have the sci-fi looking and the modern looking one in the main street and the sci-fi area. And if I had to turn that back with portals and the whole thing that I'm doing here, that wouldn't have worked. But oh well, that's just maybe my thing, I don't know. That's just something from the start when I saw how these worked, I was like, oh man, that's such a bummer. So yeah, working on these little waterfalls over here. We're just gonna make one, I think, and the other ones need to be a little bit taller, so we'll just extend this one and make it fit to all the others, and it looks really awesome. I think I changed quite a bit, guys, after I recorded this, so some things will be different at the end of it. And I think we're almost there, actually, because I don't want to show you the last waterfall that I did, because that's something I changed later on. And I think that's about it for the speed build part, so let's just move on to real time and I will tell you all about everything that I've done off screen. Alright guys, here we are, and as you can see, this area has changed quite a bit. I really love how this bridge looks, by the way, with this waterfall coming underneath it. Oh, that just looks really cool. So we have this whole village area, or town area I should say, that I really want to show you. And let me just start off over here with this Cosmic Cow building. And it seems they are closed, probably because I haven't upped their pay yet. So maybe we can do that right now, why not? Let's see. Oh, you need to go to the person. No, that's why they quit. So when you're playing in sandbox and money is just not an issue at all, I just pay all of my staff $1,000 and that makes them actually just really happy with their job and with their pay, of course, who wouldn't be? So that's really something that helps a lot when you're just struggling with your staff quitting all the time. That's really just not a nice thing when you're playing in sandbox and not really focusing on the managing side as much. So now they can open up. Normally I do this in the park management screen, of course. And just over here. But for now, because it's just two buildings, I thought it would be okay just to do it like this. So they are open now. So we have this little cosmic cow building. This one isn't that complicated. I didn't do a lot about it. Just some basic details, some colors in there that just really give it an accent and make it look a little bit of fun. We have this building that you've already seen. I did change the roof a little bit. I don't know, this is not my favorite building, but it's fine for what it is. We have the toilet building that you've already seen, the entrance building over here, or gate I should say, with an information desk on there. I don't know, I didn't show you anything in real time, of course. So let me just show you the details a little bit. The backside of this building is pretty cool, even though you can't really see it that well. But I will be putting these up as blueprints. Not this episode though. We'll see when I get to that point. Maybe I want to tweak some stuff a little bit more. But yeah, I really like these buildings. Most of them, I put a lot of effort into it. Just enough so that it stands out from each other. So we have this Pipshot building, which I will show you how that looks on the inside. Nothing special, just a fairly simple thing, and you can actually get the pass just right. Over here I see I didn't do this part right, but we can change that later. So it's very basic. We don't really have signs for Pipshot yet anyway, so that's something. This is just another reason why I don't really want to put it up as a blueprint yet. Maybe I will just wait until the update comes out and I can just make them perfect and the way I like it before I just put it up as a blueprint. So we have Missy Good over here. Like I said, I don't really like those signs with just the big donuts on it and stuff like that, but this one is a little bit artistic. I like this one and I just put another sign into this one so that it looks like it's overlapping, like it's one piece. I really like that. Every building has just a little bit of a different thing. They are not facades, so the backsides are done as well. This one you've already seen. I added a lot of chimneys to all of them. So yeah, you can basically just paste these all over the place and don't have to worry about how the backside looks and stuff like that. You can just use them however you want. Oh, hey! And we have the princess over here. So, we have a gulpy building. I really like this building. This is one of the last ones I did. Let me just also show you the inside. So, we have all the gulpy shops in here. A sign over there with a bench. I kept it fairly basic on the inside because there were just so many buildings I had to make. This one has some cool little details on there. It's just kind of copied over to all the sides, so it's not a big difference on each side. Backside is pretty cool as well, because this is something you're gonna see from if you walk over to this side or back. You will see the backside of these buildings, so I thought it was pretty important they look cool as well. And I would, when I just take you through these like this, it doesn't seem like a lot, but man, if you have to build these over and over again, whew, that takes a lot of creativity to just keep up with that. We have another wooden building. This one is just to fill up some space because there is no way you can attach a path to this side. So we do have a few shops left that I would like to use. This one I did also last episode, of course, so I thought it would be a little bit of fun to have something higher up over here and then also a piece that's on the lower side. And yeah, this just looks really cool. Also from the stairs when you go up, that's also something I didn't really know how I would fill up this space exactly, but it worked out pretty well with these towers and stuff like that. So we have this one, and I think I want a right over here if it fits. We'll have to see about that. Maybe we'll make this building part of the queue line or something, but yeah, you can walk underneath here and get to this place from over here, or you can get from, you can get down from this over here when you just are on the upper side of the town. I really like how this looks. I do still need to do a lot of small things, like this is a table that I made for the spooky area, I believe, so I thought let me get that one in. I think I want to make some new chairs and have them over here, so you can have a lookout on the right that's gonna be here probably, and the coaster that's gonna be there definitely. We still need to do some stuff over here, but a fun thing that I did was I put down these large tents and I put a sign on them. I put this wall, the shop front on here, and yeah, really cool how you have a shop in the tent like this. So we'll probably do a few more of those. We have the fries one over here as well, and we'll just see how we fill up this area when we get to that point. For now I just really need a break and work on a coaster or something, because of all the building was just really a lot of work. We have an entertainment point here integrated into the fountain. That's why I deleted the water in here. I think this just looks a little bit better. I created this border from all these pieces. What's it called? Classic brick decorative course, probably, yeah. So that is a little bit more messy than I would like most of the time, but still it does the job, and I think it's good enough for now at least. So that is the whole town area, guys, for now. I think it's pretty cool, and with this part over here behind it, I think it just finishes it kind of off, because if you would just have a circle with buildings over here, that would be very random coming out of this forest with just one big structure. And now we actually have something that looks like a little bit of a village behind it, and yeah, I really like how that looks. So let me just show you up close what I did here. I think I made this one a little bit later, so she's not just standing there out of nowhere. It's pretty cool how that looks. We have the sign over here. I deleted the western thing at all the others as well, because that's not something we're gonna do anymore. Sad. But yeah, if I want to do western in the future, I don't know if that's gonna happen soon or maybe in just a long way in the future, but for now I just really feel like if I'm gonna do western, I'm gonna do it right, and I'm gonna do it in a desert park and do it fully. So yeah, we'll see about that. Maybe I will just take on smaller projects like I said before, and make a ride that's specifically for a mine train or something like that, and fully decorate that to the best of my ability, instead of just making a whole park. So I made this little island over here, so that we can have these little bridges that I just basically made out of, this is just the wooden fence that I sunk in, so it looks like it's standing on these posts, and just the wooden, very simple, these wooden planks. Let's get rid of that. So yeah, this area is really awesome. I really like this. We have this little waterfall over here, and we have all these little houses that's all connected with these little bridges. You can get everywhere. I added some more over here, so it's just a full area of this. Now the only thing is you only will be able to see it from the monorail station, of course, which is maybe a bit of a waste. So what we could do is just have this coaster over here, start over here, go over this area, maybe loop around the whole village part over here and close by the fairy forest and the river rapids. That would be actually really cool. Would be a really large coaster probably, but yeah, maybe we can do something cool with that. As you can see, I deleted the whole area that was dedicated for pirates. I really wanted to do it, but it was such a small space, and I just know that if I want to do something, I'm gonna do it fully and fully dedicated. So with a small area like that, it's just not gonna work, and I'm gonna struggle a lot with just compensating what I can do and what I can do. So I just decided, let's just make this a cool, full fantasy area, and we'll have enough room for a coaster over here and maybe some more scenery. I was thinking maybe to sculpt some huge mushrooms or something like that. We'll see if I get to that point or if I think of something else to do, and then we'll have this castle area, of course, which we're gonna work on, I think, lastly for this area. So now what I did over here is also a big change. Like I said, we're not gonna do Western anymore, and I felt like I needed to change this up a little bit. So what we have now is I made this piece of water cove kind of thing, mountain cove kind of thing, and I just extended it all the way to over here. This way we had some room for a waterfall right here, but also on the fantasy side, and that's something I felt like that was missing, because these smaller ones you don't really see from a lot of angles. Except maybe for the last one. That's why I also wanted to change that one, because it was over here and you just won't be able to see it when you walk from this side. So I just wanted to have something over here, and also at the river rapids I think it was pretty fitting to have a waterfall, and that just makes this whole area look finished, and I really like how that looks. My game, you see the frame rate is getting pretty slow again, and that's definitely because of all of the effects that I put in here. We'll just have to deal with it. I don't have any problem with building. You can just see it goes a little bit on the lower frame rate side here. It's not good, but oh well. Let's see what is left. A nice overview is pretty cool. Can see how much we did in these few episodes and how much faster this has gone by than what I did in here. Now what we could do over here is still maybe have a very small pirate area. That's something I was thinking, but I really have to be behind that fully, because I'm already at the point that I kind of want to move on, and I have some new ideas I really want to work on, but for now I still just really need to finish this park. That's definitely something I really need to do. I need to finish this for myself and for you guys, so that's definitely something I'm gonna do. But now that I'm looking at it, we could actually have a smaller pirate area over here. For now I just connected it to the main street. I thought maybe I can extend the main street, but now that I'm thinking about it, it's still possible to make a dedicated pirate area to a coaster. I think it's gonna be a themed coaster, and that's about it if I would do that. So we can still get this back. I changed this a little bit, and we can still get this back and make a portal to the pirate area over here if that's still something we're gonna do. But yeah, look at this, guys. This park is almost completely done, and I'm really proud, and I really love how it all looks. So I think I'm gonna leave it with that. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one.